He got his learning in New Orleans. He came to New Orleans, I'm not quite sure, but I'll say around 1916. Of course, these are all New Orleans riffs. Louis came to New York some years ago after playing in King Oliver's band and from the plantation in Chicago. That whiskey is lovely. They invaded New York with a terrible band, in spite of the fact that they had some of the very best musicians in the world into jazz music. Louis Russel isn't considered a jazz piano player because he cannot play jazz. I'm playing this in the typical jazz tempo. But he's a very good musician, and he can knock the bird's eyes down. He invaded New York with this thing and happened to get a job after King Oliver had failed with these great musicians, and had to leave town. He even stole a few of my men when he left Chicago. He didn't know that it was better to have some fellas that could play together than have a bunch of stars that couldn't. So he failed in his trip to New York at the Savoy Ballroom. Louis stayed. He finally got a job at a place in New York called The Mess, run by Johnny Carey. And he wrote this number as a kind of theme and named it. No, Louis Russel is not a sissy. He wrote this number and called it Call of the Freaks, finding there were so many freaks in the city of New York that were so bold they would do anything for a dollar and a half. When he started playing this thing, why they would start walking. They all become to know the tune. They throw their hands way up high in the air and keep a stride with the music and walking. And of course they used to have a little voice in here that goes like this. Stick out your can, here come the garbage man. Stick out your can, here come the garbage man. Just stick out your can, here come the garbage man. Just stick out your can, here come the garbage man. The freaks would be marching, I'm telling you. Stick out your can, here come the garbage man. They stick themselves out in the rear.